winter in Afghanistan is never easy, but this is the first since the withdrawal of the U.S. and its allies and the Taliban takeover. In response, the international community cut off non-humanitarian aid, froze Afghanistan's assets abroad, and imposed sanctions on the new government. All those factors, plus crippling drought and already fragile institutions, have led to an economic and humanitarian crisis. As John Ray of Independent Television News reports, Afghans are going to desperate lengths to keep themselves and their family members alive.
Kabul is no place to be young in this bleak midwinter. There is snow on the mountains, a chill in every heart, and only the coldest comfort for a family of six children. The oldest is 14, the youngest just one. Their father is dead, they are destitute, and their mother is desperate. We first found her at the local market, her children laid out like goods for sale, begging strangers for help, but help, there is none. So for a few pennies, they polish shoes. It does not earn them any kind of living, not even enough to buy bread. They have barely a roof over their heads. Their stove is stone cold. And the baby is sick with fever. I'm desperate. We're beaten, she says. There's no more we can do. Oh God, I have nothing. When the Taliban arrived, much Western funding vanished as quickly as US troops. Today's boots on the ground belong to the army of urban poor. The economy has collapsed, there is no work and little relief. In this place we have no money, no doctor, not even a piece of bread, says Tawuz Khan. Most of the children you see here, they're orphans. Their fathers have been killed in the war. But now we will discover peace brings no respite. A child appears at the door. Her father makes us an astonishing offer.
He wants to sell.
If there is anybody to buy, so I'm ready to sell it.
It sounds callous, but it is more a measure of Sahib Khan's misery. An educated man, once a school teacher. Better times, now gone.
The Taliban say we have peace. But what good is peace when our children are sick and I have debt collectors at my door?
If you sell your daughter, what will happen to her?
There is nothing else I can do. I am not able to care for her.
Life has never been easy here, but now it is harder than ever.
To the people here, all these children, it doesn't matter that the Americans have gone and that the Taliban have come back. What does matter is that they just don't have enough to eat and that it feels like they are being forced slowly but inevitably towards starvation.
They work miracles at the children's hospital. They need to for babies like Hazibullah, whose survival seems against all odds. Amina fights for breath, her malnourished body unable to fight off infection. Her mother tells her she will stay at her bedside until God decides her daughter's fate. For week after week, staff worked without pay. They still lack medicine and equipment, and sometimes even miracles won't do.
We have, in the previous months, mortality was about 200.
200 children?
200 children was died in here.
But underlying it always is hunger, it's just hunger.
And women who are pregnant and hungry give birth prematurely, so it is two to an incubator. A baby has stopped breathing. His name is Mohammed Anwar. For an agonizing moment, his life hangs in the balance. But this fight ends in victory.
He got a new life after his citation.
Yet sometimes there is as much grief as there is joy. This newborn is called Sabah. His twin brother has already died. And his own span in this unhappy land will be measured in days. His mother has been warned. They do not have the drugs to save him.
Heartbroken, it's very bad for us. We are hopeless for them.
Four decades of fighting has ended, but yet another generation seems born to suffer.
There's just no words. Very, very hard to watch. That was John Ray of Independent Television News.